Hey guys, what's up? This is Chris with a review of a classic remake. Of course, you have probably seen or played Duck Hunt from Halo 3 or Halo Reach. It of course returns in Halo 4 and just as fun as always. This is called Hatched Duck Hunt, created by Hatched Harp. So if you're unfamiliar with what kind of map this is, it's similar to the Halo type map that I've recently reviewed. If you're the Flood, your job is basically to reach the survivor and kill him. And if you're the one sniping, and if you're basically the survivor, your job is to kill as many Flood as you can before they reach you and then kill you, of course. Okay, so the map has 5 levels, each teleporting you a level higher than the one you just completed and reached. Of course, a few notes when spawning, beware of the first obstacle here, as usually a lot of people do die from this just by bumping each other in mid-air and then just not even landing it right. So one tactic to survive here is just to wait for everyone to go first and then jump on and off the barricades, and be very careful with your initial jump because, you know, a lot of people do mess up and then they can't really play until the round ends. Right, so how to survive. Usually it is best to be in the back to draw the least amount of detection. There's also fusion coils, so survivor can see quite easily being where he or she is, but rather harder for the Flood to spot when you're playing, which is most likely all the time, right? So the Flood is the 15th amount of people. So in most cases, it's more safe to be backed up against the wall and farther away from the possible fusion coils that are hidden, which are pretty much on the higher levels. And to throw off the sniper periodically, just stop and move backward and don't let them know your next move. Just kind of act a little strange, maybe take some cover and wait for somebody to go back, because they can't really keep an eye on everybody. So if you and your friend are kind of separated, you can just like, you guys can keep switching places and keep going forward if you're only down to like 3 or 4 people in a lobby. So yes, it's best to take every opportunity to take cover. So lastly, the tips for the sniper, and then forget about the survivor, of course. I'd say shoot the person not in front, but in the person in the third or fourth place of the front, because that's about the comfort point when I'm playing for someone to just like not be worried about being in the spotlight. Because when I'm playing, I just think about, oh, you know, that person's way ahead of me. Of course, the sniper's not going to shoot me. So I just run. I just basically follow them, not worrying about how much cover I'm hiding behind or anything like that. And also, if you are the sniper, of course, don't forget to use your explosives to your advantage. Lay the crosshair down on one and just wait for bypassers, and it does work, trust me. Alright guys, well that is it. Tutorial to download this map and game type are down below. For the rest of the video, as usual, I'll just let some gameplay roll from a game night. Be sure to drop a like if you enjoyed. This has been Chris, signing out. Peace.
It's the first time.
Yes,
you
do.
Over at my desk, brother.
It's the hardest part of the whole thing.
Oh,
yeah, the first part is the hardest.
Oh, no.
Oh, come on.
Yeah, he sniped me.
Nick, how to make wooden sizing.
No one jumped off.